iron has been forged since ancient times. But it wasn't until the Middle Ages that the Swedish kings realized it could also be exported. This was brought on by German miners and merchants, who were given privileges to conduct business in the lands. Sweden, once a purely agrarian society, had taken the first steps towards a new economic structure and a closer integration with European civilization. Around the Lake Mälar, many furnaces were established, producing thousands of tons of iron for export to Lübeck. However, since the foreign trading vessels were unable to enter the lake, a port of shipment was established, to be called Stockholm. On the continent, the iron industry was evolving quickly, and to keep abreast and maintain its profits, the Swedish producers needed modernization. The raw material, the Swedish iron ore, was extraordinarily pure, carrying low levels of sulfur. But at a time when the raw material was much less worth than the refined product, the so-called bar iron, it simply wasn't enough. There was a need for new know-how. But from where? In the beginning of the 17th century, the continent was ravaged by wars and religious persecution. Skilled craftsmen that had emigrated from Wallonia to Holland found an opportunity to live and work in one of Holland's main provider of cannons, Sweden. Bringing new skills and techniques, they proved invaluable to the Swedish Royal Ironworks and Armories. Louis de Guerre, a wealthy Dutch entrepreneur, was also instrumental at the time of the introduction of Walloon blast furnaces. During the following centuries, Swedish bar iron would be exported to Britain, Holland, France, Portugal, and the Mediterranean. Employing tens of thousands of workers, it became the backbone of the Swedish economy. At Uppsala University, not far from the old furnaces, scientists are developing new, better materials with designed properties, incorporating the latest technologies and scientific findings, bringing them to market through spin-off enterprises. At VBN Components, one of these spin-offs, tools are produced in the hardest steel ever, thanks to additive manufacturing.
We reached an exciting stage in our production process.
For me, as a former cemented carbide development and material scientist, it is truly exciting to present this.
When high-speed steels aren't heat-resistant enough, or where traditional cemented carbides are too brittle, our new material comes in. This material is of course a perfect match for metal cutting tools, but also for woodworking tools, wear parts in food industry, plastic processing tools, rock drilling equipment, and a large number of application areas with high demands in heat and wear resistance. A year ago, VBN Components launched the world's hardest steel. Today, we're excited to announce our next achievement, a 3D-printed cemented carbide.
This signifies a giant leap in innovation on par with the introduction of cemented carbides for about 70 years ago.
If you're an engineer choosing a material, of course you want the best material for your end application, but you'll be constrained by the way the material and the component are manufactured, and this can seriously limit your options. Let's say you're aiming for a material with high wear resistance and extreme heat resistance. Then you would most likely go for a cemented carbide, a hard metal. Since the manufacturing process is difficult, it has limitations in cost, component size and complexity, and there's a need for very large series. You might actually never be able to choose a cemented carbide. At VBN Components, we're about to change this.
Our R&D work has been done mainly in collaboration with the Angstrom Laboratory at Uppsala University. Thanks to these instruments, we've been able to do all the necessary material development despite having very limited resources. We are at one of the best material labs in the world. We have earlier shown that by choosing Vibenite for tools, you'll likely reduce the material consumption by more than 90%. This comes from tool manufacturing and performance of the tool. The high yield opens up for an entirely new avenues of material development. We can select new types of elements for alloying and achieve even better material performance. And this is exactly what we've done in our latest material, Vibenite 480. It is the first 3D printed cemented carbide in the world. One of the most important development steps in Vibenite 480 is the alloying principle, which allows us to use traditional gas atomized powder. This is a large scale powder manufacturing at low cost. And this is a huge win. So what is cemented carbides or hard metals? Well, it is a large group of metals invented to be able to stand the wear demands from tungsten bulb filament production. Today, it is well used in metal cutting tools, rock drill bits, or as the small rotating ball in front of your pen. The cemented carbide materials have extremely good combination of hardness, toughness, and heat resistance, but the cost and process complexity limits the use. And they are everything but 3D printable. And of course, Vibenite 480 adapts all the other advantages from additive manufacturing, as in our steel materials. Now it's possible to shape cemented carbide components in ways that were always considered impossible. You will see substantial gains in the end application. Like a diamond in the rough, Vibenite 480 can be polished to fit your applications. We are now able to answer that question. Yes, you can.